What's up guys, this is Hart back with another video. Before we get started, make sure you hit that like and subscribe for more video content. In this video, I will be answering a question from one of my viewers, and the question reads, can you please explain about the on-the-fly projection in QGIS 3.10 and how the CRS settings in both project and general settings work? All right, so I think in an earlier video, I may have talked a little bit about CRS settings, but I don't think I talked at all about general settings. But let's get into it. What I did, since the most recent version is 3.14, I actually kind of did like a comparison here, and I will flip back and forth. When I go back and edit this video, I'll put on here so you'll know whether it's 3.10 or 3.4, which one I have up currently. So let's get into it. First of all, the way that you would know which one you have, you would need to go to help and you come down here to the about and see right here 3.14. Okay, and then for the other one that I have here, as you see a slight little change, help, about, then you see 3.10. okay, so let's go ahead and get this question answered. So I'm going to stay over here in 3.10 and then we'll kind of look back over into the other one when we get to the second part of the question. So let's go ahead and go to the first part is on the fly. So what is on the fly? Well, on the fly is a setting in QGIS and in certain GIS mapping applications that allows a modification during the importation of a specific feature or layer. So each feature, each layer has a CRS. Okay, it has some kind of reference system for it to be able to be placed on your canvas. And what on the fly allows is that when you bring in a CRS that is different from your project CRS, it will automatically recalculate the incoming CRS to the project CRS. Okay, so let's say if I had a WGS type CRS and I want to go to pseudo Mercator. If the WGS is my project default CRS, the pseudo Mercator will be transformed into the WGS, and that is on the fly. And what it cuts down on is a lot of problems when you bring in a file, two files that are different in CRS, the newest file imported may not even show up because it can't be calculated into the CRS, and on the fly fix that problem. Now, let's go ahead and talk about the CRS settings in project. So if we go up here to project, our project tab, and we scroll down to properties, in the properties, there is a tab called CRS here. Let me move this up a little bit. CRS. Now, in this tab, you are able to type in whatever CRS you want into this filter or this search box. And different choices will appear for that specific query. Okay, and then you find the one that you want. You can look through its documentation here and find which one that you want that corresponds to the map that you're trying to create. In this also, there is this little phrase here, no projection or unknown or non-earth projection. If you have no projection, then this will make the layers of your map transform from a 3D or a three-dimensional orientation to a 2D orientation. Okay, And when it transforms from this 3D orientation to this 2D, what this does is whatever layer comes in, it will be plotted on your canvas specifically by the coordinates that it brings in. Okay, so what this means, if it comes in without a CRS, in previous videos we've seen that a CRS brings measuring or measurement units with it. If you mark no projection, you will have no measurement units. You will just have coordinates from point to point to point and no reference system. Okay, so just know that if you have that checked. And this is pretty much identical in the 3.4. Let me skip over to the 3.4. Project properties. I said 3.4. 3.14. Okay, so it's identical over here. Now there will be more changes on the second part of the question, which is the general setting. So let's go back to 3.110. And let's go into settings here. We'll scroll down to options. And let me move this up a little bit. Okay, so here is where the on the fly, where you could activate on the fly in older versions of QGIS. It used to be right here. There was a box that you could check or uncheck, and you would mark enable on the fly. That is no longer here. Okay, but I'm going to tell you about that in just a little bit. So you have several options here. When a project is created, what do you want to do? Do you want to use CRS from the first layer added, or use a default CRS? Now, if you use a CRS from the first layer added, when you add a layer here, if that layer has a CRS, the whole project will be set to that CRS. If you use a default CRS, you can actually go and find whatever default CRS that you want to use every single time, and it will do that every single time. It will make that CRS the default. But I like to use the CRS from the first layer added, because usually when I open up a project, the first layer that I add is the CRS that I want to stick with. And if I need to modify that, I can do that afterwards. Anyway, the next thing is CRS for layers. What is the default CRS for a layer that is brought in? And this works almost just like this. This is for the complete project. This is for the layers that are brought in. If you want to manipulate, and by the way, the on the fly is a default now. And so to change the on the fly, or to be able to deactivate the on the fly, you will need to do that here for a specific layer. So by default, you have this default. You have four settings here, and it has use default layer CRS, which is this line here. Or you can use project CRS, which is whatever the first layer is added, or would be the default layer here. Or you could prompt for CRS. So if you get a prompt for CRS, every time that you add a layer to your project, you will get the function of this button. Not this button exactly, but you will get the function of this button. So I'll click this, and it'll bring up a dialog box like this, and you'll be able to choose a CRS for each layer that you bring in. Okay, the next thing is leave as unknown CRS. So you remember when we talked about no CRS, or unknown, or none earth. This is what this is. This is basically when you bring that layer in, it will specifically be plotted by the coordinates that it holds. Okay, the next thing is the datum transformations. So datum transformations are can be calculated, or they can be the transformations can be applied to a CRS in multiple ways. If the datum, if the CRS or the layer a CRS has multiple transformations, you will be able to go and select which CRS, or not which CRS, which transformation you would like for the CRS. So if this is checked, ask for datum transformation if several are available. What that will allow you to do, and let me just add some type of transformation. When you try to add a datum transformation, all you need is a source CRS. And let's say that I have my source CRS is WGS and my destination CRS is pseudo Mercator. If there were any transformations for these, they would show up in this box, okay? The other option that you have here is hide depreciated transformations. Now, what does depreciated transformations mean? This could mean that these transformations cause problems in QGIS. The calculations may be incorrect. Something is wrong with those transformations. And if you check this box, those transformations will be erased from this, and only the transformations that are fully functional will be left here. Okay, so that is our datum transformations. That's how you add. If you do add, you can actually select a datum transformation and delete in the same way with this minus button. So now this is 3.10. Let's go and see the differences over in 3.14. So let's go over there. Now we're in 3.14. And let's go to our settings, options, and we are in our CRS for 3.14 now. Now, I'm not going to go over all this again. This is the exact same. But for the datum transformations, let's go ahead and add a datum transformation. So here you can see that there is a transformation here for this specific transformation. What if I change this destination transformation or destination CRS to pseudo Mercator? Okay, so there is a popular visualization here, and down here you get this you get the name of the specific transformation, the area of use, which is the world, which you can see in red what area of use is in effect for this specific transformation. Then you see your identifiers, how this can be identified as a CRS. Now down here, unlike the 3.10, we have two other options: show superseded transformations and allow fallback transformations if preferred operation fails. So let's say you have a transformation here, but this transformation is has problems or fails, then it will fall back to the default transformation that you had. On the other option, show superseded transformations or transforms, what that means is, let's say, let's use them for example, cars. If you have a 2018 vehicle and it's 2020 now, so we get a 2020 vehicle. The 2018 vehicle was superseded by the 2020. That doesn't mean that the transformation doesn't work. It just means that there is a newer model out. Okay, I hope that makes sense. So the last thing that we'll cover is this planimetric measurement. Okay, so what you need to understand about planimetric measurements is that it doesn't mean planet like the Earth. It means plane. Okay, so think about a plane. You're measuring inside a plane or across a plane. Now, when you measure in a plane, you're not measuring X, Y, and Z. You're not measuring 3D measurements. You're measuring a two-dimensional plane of X and Y. And this is what this option does. Do you want planimetric measurements, which means just X and Y, or do you want X, Y, and Z? If it is checked, you got your X and Y measurements. If it is unchecked, you have your X, Y, and Z, which correspond to spherical objects. Okay? Now, when you think about topographical planes, where you have like mountain ranges, or you have houses, buildings, things that stand up off the ground, off of a spherical object, sometimes to identify those features, you need the X, Y, and Z. But on a plane, if you just want the location of that object, you want the location of that building, you don't need an X, Y, and Z. You just need an X and Y to give you a specific coordinate for that feature on a flat 2D canvas. Hopefully that makes sense. And I think I went over everything that needs to be gone over. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them in the comment section. Don't forget to like and subscribe. And as always, I will see you in the next one. Peace.